Well, hello, good people. Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to say thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. Hope everybody's having a great day. It is hump day, and not a usual day, hump day, as it is. This is, of course, we have New York stinking Giants, and I'm not sure that I can call anybody stinking the way the Cowboys have been playing. That we literally are pretty stinky our damn selves. And hopefully we can get ourselves back on track. Putting a little more light on here. I don't have the ceiling lights on. Hopefully we can find a way to get back on track. And we have had some real issues in this game. Now, one thing I want to point out is the weather is going to be very, very wet. There's been a lot of rain the last few days. And there's, you know, a lot of more moisture that's going to be coming tomorrow, and it's going to be wet. So that's going to make it tough sledding for the passing game. But we have some news on the Giants that are a little bit more beat up than we are. As expected, Giants will be without two starting cornerbacks, Andre Jackson and rookie Drew Phillips. Also, Darius Slayton is questionable with a thumb. Now, typically, when a guy is questionable, they usually play. Usually, when they're doubtful, they don't. So, the Giants will definitely be shorthanded. The Cowboys will be packing their bags. Actually, their bags should already be packed. And will be headed to New York to spend the night there getting ready for the Giants. And maybe, just maybe, this is what the Cowboys need. Get away from Dallas for a game and try and right the ship so we can get back and hopefully have a victory. If we're 2-2, and this is where it's funny because, God, it's 2:07 right now. I have, the Dan Salio show at 4:30 today. And, Philly 500 texted me already and said, "Are you going to show up?" And I sent him a picture of me just looking sad and pathetic. And he's like, you're taking out all the fun out of this. And I'm like, there is no fun here right now if you're a Cowboys fan. This has just been bad. And I said, I might show up today with a bag over my head. And he said, no, bro. He said, don't do it. He said, you're only 1-2. This is bad. This is when you know it's bad. That literally Philly 500 is consoling me. This is how bad it is. He said, don't put a bag over your head, man. Don't put a bag over your head. You know, you're 1-2. You can turn things around. He said, if you lose to the Giants, though, then I put a bag on your head. And that's the truth. We have to, this is, if you lose to the Giants and then you've got 10 days off until your next game to play the Steelers and you got the Lions, you got the 49ers coming up, this shit could just roll downhill real quick and get out of hand. I know we got a softer part of our schedule the second half of the season, but this is a must win. And so, you know, with CeeDee Lamb having a bad game last week and checking out and saying the right things, trying to get back, you know, on an even keel. I hope, honestly, that this is the case, that this will end up being a get-right game, that the Cowboys will go out here and they'll get a little bit right on this game. So, yeah, we don't have any margin for error right now. None. So we'll see. And I will do the Dan Salio. I'll live stream it on my channels while it's going on the Eagles channels. I tell you what, if we lose to the Giants, next Wednesday's show would probably break the internet. Because I would be clown like a mother humper. All right, good people. I appreciate y'all. Peace out.